Wow. Okay, we have some answers coming in at this point of time. But before we go into the answer, perhaps, Dr. Teo, you are a dermatologist and we all like to think that our doctors are most of the time flawless, but I have to ask you this one very important question. Have you ever experienced hyperpigmentation?
Well, I mean, I think it is human to have flaws, so nothing to be embarrassed about when you ask this question. I think that, it is important for us to realize that not all forms of hyperpigmentation are so-called age-related or even, caused by environmental exposures. I mean, I am naturally considered quite fair-skinned, so even from my teen years, I had freckles, and I still have them. They're quite faint. I'm actually not wearing makeup now, other than for lipstick. So if your camera is able to zoom in, you can see. I personally do not treat freckles because they are not in any way, related to photo aging or even any sort of pathological process. So you can see a lot of fair-skinned individuals, and especially you find in individuals with light colored eyes and red hair. These individuals genetically they have a higher tendency to develop freckles. We call them aphthalates. Now, for anybody that has even suffered from a mosquito bite, you know that after the bite, you do get hyperpigmentation as well. And, growing up, we all have had, bouts of physiologic acne. So even as adults, we do still see individuals who suffer from hormonal acne. And that exactly is the post-inflammation hyperpigmentation that I was talking about earlier, that Thiamidol can effectively target. So nobody is flawless. Maybe with the help of Thiamidol, we all will be.
Thank you so much for your just straight up honesty and making me feel a little bit better about myself as well. Because, I mean, from what I see, your skin looks glowing and it looks absolutely beautiful and gorgeous.